Do you have time for a quickie?
Okay, so in this episode, I'm going to go over a new feature in After Effects 2023 that is a major, major update. So over here on the left, I've got After Effects 2022, and over here, 2023. The feature I'm going to go over is related to track matting. I've got the same exact text and the same exact text animation on both sides, as you can see, for my 2022 and 2023 After Effects. So in every version previous to 2023, if I wanted this text just to show up in the middle of my screen, there are a number of ways to do it. Now, I have text animator tutorials that show you how to use a mask to do that, and also have a set matte tutorial, which is how I would recommend doing this if you have more than one text layer. But that's been alleviated with 2023 because now you can track matte more than one layer. Again, if I was using text animators, this wouldn't be necessary, but this is certainly one way to reveal text. So I'm just going to go in here and add in a shape layer, and I'm going to add in a quick rectangle and a fill, and I'm just going to stretch that out all the way across. And let me just make sure this is going to be covering my text, so maybe make this a little bit bigger. If I wanted to reveal this text within this area where the shape layer is, I would normally just go alpha matte, and it will only show up within that layer, like that. Problem is that if I want to have more than one text layer do that, so say for example, if I duplicate this, as you can see, it automatically moves your text layer above your matte layer. One way that I've shown to do this, you can remove this alpha matte, and then you can go to set matte under your effects and presets, and then let's just go ahead and add a set matte to this first layer, and we're going to set our matte to our shape layer, which is layer one. I'm just going to copy that effect and paste that to this other text layer. So now if I move this down and say I'll change this text to 7 minute AE, for example, and make sure that you take off this track matte for alpha matte, because our set matte is now going to be applying our matte and we no longer need our layer to do that. We'll set that to no track matte, and if we watch it play back, both of these layers are using this matte layer as a track matte. So that's one way of doing this with set matte. So now in 2023, the thing's really cool is that After Effects has been updated. So let's do pretty much the same thing. We'll go in here and add in a shape layer. We'll give that shape layer a rectangle and a fill. Stretch this all the way across and make it a little bit taller. If we go to our track matte column here, we can see already that we have a different option. So see how we just have the option for none and one. We don't have an option for alpha matte, luma matte, alpha inverted, luma inverted. Let's go back to 2022, go to our track matte column. When you open that up, you have those options here. And the reason why is because in every version previous to 2023, you can only matte one layer at a time. In 2023, they've updated that, which is a huge update. See, now if I choose shape layer one, it's using that as an alpha matte automatically. And you may be going, well, how do you know it's an alpha matte? There's an icon right here. If you hover over it, you can see it says alpha matte. And if you click it again, it goes to luma matte. And then if you want to invert it, you have this box right here. Click to invert this matte. So all of your options are right here. So this essentially is working like a set matte. Let's duplicate this layer, move it over, and you can already see it's using this matte layer. Change my text to 7 minute AE. Watch it play back. Both of these text layers are using this matte layer without using set matte. We're doing it straight from our layer. And this is a very powerful upgrade because now you can keep all of your mats very organized. You know, like if I had a very, very long list of text and I had mats set all over the place, you can attach those layers to the mat layers from anywhere in your timeline. Whereas in every version before 2023, your mat layer had to be placed right on top of your layer. Let's take off this set mat here and we'll do it the old fashioned way where we just do an alpha mat. We'll take off this set mat. If I wanted to go the alpha matte route, in order for this text to show up here, I would have to duplicate our matte layer, put it on top, set our 7 minute AE to alpha matte. You just double your layers every time. So that's the old way of doing things. So if you're in a version before 2023 and you need to do an animation like this, I highly recommend that you use set matte. However, if you're using 2023, your options are exponentially greater because you can set your matte layer anywhere in your stacking order. It does not have to come right above your text layer anymore. And this goes for anything you matte, whether it's text, images, vectors, footage, anything like that. So if you're up to date and you're using After Effects 2023, check out the new matte system that has been updated. And I guarantee you, you will love this change. I know I use it all the time, and it's something that's a huge game changer.